Thank you all for coming out. I want to thank, first of all, thank Fabiola for blessing us with her incredible artwork. I think you all are going to be in for a treat learning more.
Awesome to see such a beautiful crowd, a diverse crowd, and we're excited to bring Fabiola Jean-Louise's vision to life here at HSA. And before we get started talking about rewrite history, I want Fabiola to kind of give us the journey prior to rewriting history. Because a lot of times we want to focus on the here and now, but it's the journey that makes everything special.
So the journey is a long one. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, we can speak up a little bit.
So I was kind of hanging out in Miami for a little while, left New York to be warm and mother my children. And my start, though, is in the arts. I went to high school fashion. I became really annoyed with the industry, and I left. And after just, you know, starting my family, doing all those things that you're, I guess, supposed to do, I left. I went to Miami, and at the time, I was just living as a single parent to my three children. And I don't know, I said, you know, forget about this art stuff. It's not gonna pay off. My parents they were very supportive and loved me, but you know, they wanted more from me. So they said, you know, you should probably think about medicine. You're smart enough to. So I did. And I majored in biology. And I think about two semesters before graduating, I don't know, something happened and my heart was hurting and life was just going on. And I decided that I wanted to do something that didn't require words. I came across an article about conceptual photography one day while I was dealing with my life dramas, and I thought, I can do that, I think. I don't know how, you know, I'm studying biology, life is crazy, but I think I can try this. So I actually, my first photograph that's not on my website, but is on my Facebook, was taken with a BlackBerry cell phone. I taped it to a chair, I got into the frame, I took the shot, and I edited it. And when I realized that I could actually do something called conceptual photography, I was like, that's it. I don't know what this means, but I'm doing something because I don't need to use words to do this.
Well, you know, I'm interested in talking about rewriting history because of the significance of where we are right now. We're in Black History Month, and I'd like to dedicate this particular talk to all of the ancestors that have transitioned prior to us being here, because without them, we wouldn't be here. So a lot of the pioneers in art, the Robert Bierdens, the Jacob Lawrences, the Ernie Barneses of the world inspired us to be where we're at. I went to school in North Carolina Central University, and Ernie Barnes used to come by the art department all the time. And he told me some information that I would love to pass on to the students here. And he came into the space and said, how you do anything is how you do everything. And that stuck with me because here we are right now, 2016. We're dealing with a lot of issues that a lot of us really don't want to talk about. But it's prevalent, it's present, and we need to really just take the time to notice what's going on around us, be aware. So with this this work, Rewriting History, Fabiola has decided to take us back into time to bring us fast forward to where we are right now. What brought you to this space to create this body of work?
Anger. And hurt.
Okay.
I was watching the news about another brown and black body that had been murdered by police brutality at that time, that story. My previous work before Rewriting History was very Afrofuturistic, sci-fi. I've been photographing brown and black bodies since I decided to pick up the camera. It was very important for me as a photographer to tell stories that I could relate to, not tell stories or feature bodies that really we know those stories already. And so by the time I got to the place of Rewriting History, I really wanted to do something that would talk about what was happening now, but would also include a passion for me as far as what do I like to look at when I go to the museums, the paintings. Right. I am attracted to these paintings when I go. I love them, you know, Rembrandt's. Just his artistry is just amazing, just the way these portraits are made. However, I always try to put myself into the subject's position, and it's really hard to do that because they don't reflect me, and they don't reflect the black man in my community. And so when I saw this news clip, I thought, you know, how can I make that work? How can I take these two things, something that reflects me and hopefully my community, as well as these paintings that I love to see, and put them together? I really wasn't trying to do something new in that sense. I was just really trying to tell a story with the things that I love. And so I decided, you know, wouldn't it be nice now with this news clip, wouldn't it be nice to just rewrite that? What if none of this was reality? What if we never knew what this was, this thing that's brought us to here, where, you know, black men and women are being murdered by police officers. And so I said, I want to rewrite this history. And then I think the universe just dropped it in my lap, because I said, I wanted to rewrite it, but I wanted to period pieces. Right. And then I said, well, I can't really afford the fabric to do those pieces, right, but then why should I? Because rewriting is paper, so let's make it out of paper.
Right, that's awesome. We want to incorporate this entire space to be a part of the show. And the beautiful thing about this is that from any vantage point, you can feel the energy of Fabiola's work. You can understand her vision and the delicacy of her gowns and the presentation of it. And I want to get into the aspect of texture, because we are layers of texture. We are the texture of society, the fabric of the interwovenness of who we are as US citizens or Americans or whatever you claim to be. But the texture of this show, I want you to go into detail about the texture.
That's actually the first prototype. She knows, my model, Deborah. Okay.
Yes, model's in the house tonight. Thank you for coming out. Yes.
That was the first gown that I made, and I did not make a draft for it or anything. But I wanted the paper to tell the story. I knew that early on. I wanted somehow to put the story and the life into it. And so I chose to stain it with coffee, because I knew that coffee has a history of slavery, all right, that. And that was my way of putting the story into the paper. And that's another part of working with paper, is that it's so malleable and it's transformative and it carries so much secrets and history and all of this stuff. And it can be really obvious or it can be not. And for me, it was coffee. I don't think that was necessarily obvious for the story. But I knew that by putting that coffee texture in there or stain in there, it would add to that. But I wanted my first gown to be the sculpture. And so I started building her up and I put the chest box in there. And then with the hanging body that went in there, you know, I wanted a window to the heart and maybe the soul. And for me, that became the body that was hanging in there. And then it took me 2 weeks to make the gown. Honestly, when you say the life of the, or the texture of the gowns, they take on a life of their own.
Okay.
I don't necessarily start with how that's going to be, or know how that's going to be, but it just starts to come together. And then I met Dora. I had no idea who was going to wear the gown, but I knew that she needed to be fitting for it. I met her, and within, I don't know, 10 minutes, I was like, you've got to wear my sculpture. So, I don't know, I do this dance with my work. I start with just listening to my ancestors. That's always the first thing. I listen to my ancestors. I dream about it. I don't really think about it too much. And I look at the paper and I say, what do you want me to tell? And then once I start doing that, I'm lost for about a week. And I come together, I'm like, okay, let's make it make sense. And let's find someone to wear this that looks like one of my ancestors from this story. So they're alive for me.
Yeah.